Are you struggling to know when to use Vector or the OpenTelemetry Collector? Both of these tools are great for building observability pipelines, but they each have their own strengths and weaknesses. So let's compare them. Vector is developed by Datadog and is written in Rust, while the OpenTelemetry Collector is developed by the OpenTelemetry community and is written in Go. So they're both quite performant. They also both have a YAML configuration file, are open source, and have a similar model of collecting, processing, and exporting the three main telemetry signals. But that's really where the similarities end. So let's go a bit deeper into the differences. We're going to go through three tasks with each tool. The first task is to get unstructured logs from NGINX and convert them to structured logs. The second task is to get metrics from Docker and send them to Prometheus. And the third task is to get traces from TelemetryGen and send them to Jaeger. Let's see how they compare. For this task, I've created a Docker Compose file with NGINX forwarding requests to this app. Everything is going to run locally. And if you want to know exactly how I set this up, then check out this video. The link should be in the description. Anyway, the logs from NGINX look like this, an unstructured mess. And the task is to convert these to structured logs. We'll first do it with Vector. We can set up the Vector container like this, making sure to create a volume for the Docker socket and a volume for the configuration file. Inside the configuration file, we'll first create a source that takes the logs from Docker and just includes the logs for the NGINX container. Then we'll create a transform that takes the logs as an input and we'll transform the logs with a VRL function called parseNGINXLog. This will create a new formatted message field, taking in the old message field from the NGINX logs. Then we'll just create a sync to output the logs to the console, taking in the input of our formatted logs. After that, we'll get the structured logs, which when formatted will look like this. With the OTel collector, however, let's just say it's not so easy. First of all, the OTel collector can't read logs from a Docker socket. So we need to get the log file from the NGINX container and give it to the OTel collector container. We also need a volume for the OTel collector configuration file and to expose some ports for gRPC and HTTP. Then inside the OTel collector configuration file, we can create a receiver to grab the log file. And to transform the logs, everything is done with regex. So we'll have to use a regex parser to first pass the log line into structured fields, create a time parser to put the time field into a standard format, and then add another regex parser to extract the HTTP method, path, and protocol from the request. Then we'll create an exporter to print the logs to the console, and then we'll create our service pipeline, which takes the log file as a receiver and the console as the exporter. And after all that work, the NGINX logs will be in a structured log format. Now, it's obvious that log transformation in Vector is so much better. I mean, look at these two configs. Which one would you prefer to read? The Vector remap language, VRL, is such a joy to write and even comes with a lot of built-in functions like the parse NGINX logs that we saw before. Vector also has great log filtering, log sampling, and has really good documentation on their website. Okay, that's enough about Vector. Let's move on to the next task. For this task, we're getting logs from Docker and sending them to Prometheus. We'll start with the OTel collector. We can use the Docker stats receiver to get metrics from the Docker socket. Of course, this means OTel needs a volume to the Docker socket. Then we can use the Prometheus exporter to give metrics to Prometheus in the OTLP format. We'll set the TLS to insecure since we're using HTTP, and we can create a batch processor. The batch processor is optional in our case since we don't have a lot of data. But it's a good processor to add in general to improve performance since it batches sending the data. Then after that, we'll create our metrics pipeline, which takes the Docker metrics, processes it in batches, and exports it to Prometheus. In the Prometheus config, we need to add this OTel collector target, and we can add these optional attributes to help with querying the data. We also need to enable the OTLP receiver in Prometheus. And once we've done all of that, we should get some metrics data inside Prometheus. Okay. Let's try this with Vector. Let's use Vector's Docker stats source, but this uses a URL instead of the Docker socket. So make sure you have Docker configured to export metrics. Then we'll send metrics to Prometheus using the Prometheus exporter. And that's it. Again, a much smaller config than the OTel collector one. And if we look at Prometheus, we can see we have some metrics data. Okay, let's move on to the final task. But before we do that, I mean, looking at logs through the console and metrics through Prometheus is fine. But wouldn't it be better if there was one place to view everything? This is where BetterStack comes in. BetterStack is a web-based application that can accept data from both Vector and the OTel collector and provides beautiful UIs to view, search, and filter logs, as well as view, create, and make dashboards from metrics. But that's not all. BetterStack also offers status pages, alerts, incident management, monitoring, and much more with a really generous free tier. So go and check out BetterStack today. And we're back with the final task. For this, we're going to generate some traces using TelemetryGen, or the Telemetry Generator for OpenTelemetry, which is a utility for generating telemetry data, so traces, logs, and metrics, and we're going to send the trace data to Jaeger. We'll start with the OTel collector. Since TelemetryGen sent OTLP data via gRPC, we can easily configure that with the OTLP receiver and expose the gRPC port. Then we'll send traces to Jaeger via OTLP. And we'll finish off with our pipeline, which takes the OTLP data and exports it via OTLP to Jaeger. We also have to enable OTLP in the Jaeger container. And if we trigger some traces in TelemetryGen, we should be able to see some traces in Jaeger. Now let's try and do this with Vector. Actually, I'll save you some time and let you know that there's no easy way to send traces to Jaeger with Vector. I mean, Vector can accept OTLP data via gRPC and HTTP, and it can output all these traces to the console. But sending them to Jaeger via HTTP is a bit more complicated. Creating a HTTP sync and sending it to the Jaeger API doesn't seem to be the way to do it. It only seems to work after transforming the traces to a Jaeger-friendly format. Now, considering how easy it was to deal with logs and metrics in Vector, traces shouldn't be this difficult. If I was using the Datadog agent as a source and Datadog traces as a sync, then the whole process would be much easier. And it's also important to note that support for traces in Vector is limited, so maybe in the future, it would be much easier to send traces to Jaeger. After all that, it's clear that Vector is the winner for logs and metrics. And even though the OpenTelemetry collector has better support for traces, right now, it's a bit more complicated to use with documentation that isn't straightforward. That being said, the collector and the documentation for it might improve in the future. And if you're buying into the whole OpenTelemetry ecosystem, then it may just make more sense to use it over Vector. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you want more content like this, then be sure to subscribe.